our elected officials who showed up tonight. Not in any order of importance, just because I see people as I move across the crowd. Deborah with the MPUSD Board of Trustees, thank you for being here. Jay Parker, I see you there, thank you very much. David Chago, trying to hide his act, thank you for being here. Jason Campbell, thank you so much. Not this anybody, I don't want to be this guy.
Why don't you stand in front of the circle?
Kayla Jones is here, thank you so much, Kayla. So okay, thank you. Everybody, come here. Oh, hold on.
What are you? I just saw Nancy Kayla, is it up? Hi, too.
A lot of miles with the MPUSD Board, thank you so much for being here.
Wendy Askew.
Wendy! Oh my god! I'm so sorry. Thank you for being here tonight. Thank you to all the different community leaders and community members, people on appointed commissions, people on advisory councils, and volunteer groups. I really appreciate that you came out tonight. It means a lot to me that you would think that this is worth your time and that you would give up some of your Friday evening to listen to a few comments. So I wanted to invite Jane to say hello to everybody and introduce me. Maybe she was not prepared for that. But I want to say thank you first.
Hey everybody, it's so nice to see you here. I'm so glad to be here because I've just been at Florida for a long time, as some of you have as well. Really nice to be here to introduce John Wizard, who I have come to know in recent times. And I'm just really appreciating him. When you look at all of the things that he has been doing in his life, he just finds ways to be of service to the general public. And so he served as a public safety person. He's studying the criminalism, tell me that thing that you're doing your thesis on. Militarization of police, which is such a huge issue in our country. And he is someone who stands up for social justice. He's involved with the NAACP. And he's also very interested in the environment and environmental justice, and serves on the city's environmental committee. I just recently appointed him to the Monterey County Planning Commission. And I want to thank Keith Vanveer for being here. Long time County Planning Commissioner. And the thing that I appreciate about John is that he's willing to step up to these challenging tasks. He's not afraid to read the reams of documents that you have to read in order to do these kinds of jobs, including city council. And not just read them, but make sense of them. And then he already has a reputation on the Planning Commission for asking rather tough questions, which is a delight. So I'll let John tell you more, but he is the kind of person that I so appreciate. I appreciate his willingness to step into another level of public service, being willing to run for city council. We need the kind of leadership that he brings, the willingness to stand up for the people in whatever arenas and ask the tough questions and really follow through and get things done. So John, thank you for being willing to consider running for city council, and I think people would like to hear from you.
Thank you very much, Jay. So I'll just give you a little bit of a story. One of the things I'm really passionate about is affordable housing. And we had a housing forum with MMEP that was Matt Burt put that on. And then Jane was a co-host, Kayla was a co-host, Wendy with the school board was a co-host. The reason why affordable housing to me is such a big deal is when I was young, I vividly remember sitting on my bed, in my bedroom. The window was open. I could hear my parents outside talking, who I later learned was the landlord at the time. And he was going back and forth with them about how he was going to double the rent. Just no pattern of increase, just overnight, he was going to charge us twice as much. And you know, as a 7 or 8 year old, you know, you can't really conceptualize how difficult that would be. But now as an adult, thinking back, what kind of sacrifices my parents would have had to go through had that happened, how close we might have been to homelessness, how close we were to the devastation that comes with being evicted from a home when you have two small kids, and my little brother was probably 1 or 2 years old at that time. It's something that I don't want other people to have to go through. It's something that I want to work against by creating opportunities for people to have housing security. That's homes that are adequate, just as MBEP's message says, adequate, available, and affordable.
Yes.
And so part of that is, if you'd like, I can just pitch the mic. I could probably.
Point it upwards toward your mouth.
There you go.
Part of that is sustainable development. And while that can kind of sound like a nebulous term, kind of like, what does that really mean? Sustainable development to me means not planning and building beyond what we're capable of actually doing. How do we create affordable housing and new homes for people, but balance that with, do we have enough public safety? Do we have enough parks? Do we have enough people at City Hall to make sure that these permits are getting through in a timely manner? So there's more to just building than building, and part of that capacity to see it through all the way and to do it correctly is something that is part of the bigger project, part of the bigger equation, and making sure that we face all facets of a large project such as Campus Town, Main Gate, Seaside East, and any of the infill projects that we're going to do here in town are very important aspects that we have to make sure we don't drop the ball. Of course, the elephant in the room on the peninsula is water. We need more water. We need a sustainable and long-term future water supply that will never fail us. There's a lot of talk about how to do that, but ultimately what it comes down to is we need to find something that is environmentally sound, something that is equitable for all communities and everybody who's going to essentially pay for that program, and something that is fair for all the people involved, even if they're not part of the system. So I don't think the best idea is to put a desal plant in Marina that affects the residents of Marina. I don't think that the best idea is to continue to draw a bunch of water out of Carmel River, and I don't think the best idea is to overdraft the Seaside Basin and introduce a bunch of salt water into the aquifer that serves everybody in Seaside and Monterey. So, what's the answer? If I had the answer, I'd be in charge. But with listening to everybody's input and finding what the best thing is for each individual person and trying to meld that all together to get a big picture idea, an overview of what serves our community the best way for us to move forward, that's how I think we can change the conversation to being something that's more socially and environmentally equitable for everybody, for all the people who are also not at the table, by choice or by design. So I wanted to answer a couple of questions. If anybody had any questions, make myself available. If you don't have any questions, that's fine too.
You're what?
So everybody, I wanted to point out quickly all the people who helped me with this event. First and foremost is my girlfriend Jessica Hare. She's been instrumental in the well. It's been marvelous with the events. She's awesome, and everybody should hire her to be there. Ryan Baylor with our local Canadam, the charter group with our central committee. He's been incredibly helpful in logistics and nuts and bolts on how to do this kind of stuff. So everybody, please. Tyler Williamson, he's going to run in Monterey this Saturday, not tomorrow, next Saturday, come to his campaign kickoff event at City Hall. And then the staff here at the press club, I'm sorry, the staff here, they're here after the fact, they're normally closed, they're here for me and for us, so please give them a round of applause and buy something. In case anybody's wondering, Kayla told people today there were witnesses that she endorsed me.
Yeah. I endorsed you months ago.
Even better! She endorsed me months ago! And then. Say that again? Oh, yes, I'll get to that. Thank you for reminding me. Dennis Alexander, our mayor pro tem. He could not be here. He was supposed to be, but the forum meeting went long and he has other obligations. He's a reserve police officer in Sand City, as well as being a full-time teacher. And he has endorsed me to take his vacated seat.
All right.
Brenda Lewis on our Water Management District Board of Directors has also endorsed me. And Wendy Root Askew with our NPUSD Board of Trustees. Most importantly, I managed to cajole Jane into endorsing me. So, now, I feel like, it might be a bit of a cliche term, but I feel like the tent is getting bigger. I feel like more people are on board. I feel like more people are ready for a change in Seaside, and I want to be a part of that change, and I think with your input and your enthusiasm and your energy, we'll be able to do something fantastic in Seaside. So thank you.
All right.
On your left, and it's got tote bags that have all kinds of cool stuff in them, buttons and postcards and business cards and trifolds and remittance envelopes. Even if you don't want to give me any money, which I can appreciate, you can check a box and tell me you'd like to volunteer, put a sign in your yard, or make phone calls, or endorse me. So please take a swag bag. It's full of good stuff, and there's more than enough for everybody. And there's extra stuff there if you want to look at even more stuff. Make sure you get some of Jim's Chinese, 100 best in America. Make sure you get Angelina's bakery cookies. They're delicious. And buy something from the concessionaire. Thank you. I appreciate it.